Welcome to FX Bootcamp London. My name is Christian Stevens. Today is Tuesday, September 4th, 2007. This is your daily London session video, a review of some of what we did today in the live London session class at fxbootcamp.com. One of the trade setups we had today involved the pound USD. There were several, as you see pictured right here, there were several trades available today, most of which did begin at their best possible entry in the Moscow session. As you can see, looks like you had a 5-8 cross breaking the 55 EMA right around 2:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, about an hour before the London session takes over. Right as the London session began, you had a continued break and a cross of the 200 EMA on the pound dollar, and you can see a price move down considerably throughout the day, the remaining session. However, there was at least one very good re-entry opportunity during the London session, and from the looks of things, possibly even a re-entry during the New York session. But of course, I'm going to focus on the London session re-entry opportunity that we did go over while it was at that point. And had you missed the first entry, you would have been able to successfully have several levels of confirmation of a bounce point, an area to have a pretty good risk versus reward setup on the bounce of this 21 EMA. When price returned to the 21 EMA, you would have been able to enter your short somewhere in that arena. The nice thing about doing a retracement entry is you're able to put your stop fairly tight, say after the 55 EMA, to give yourself a nice risk versus reward, low risk, high reward kind of setup. Now, sure, we didn't know it was going to go down here, but we were expecting at least 201. Anyway, I will go further and zoom in to show you how we were able to get some kind of confirmation on that entry. Let me first scroll back to the point of the return of the 21. The first thing I want to do is back to the point where the candle itself had breached past our... You see this fine red line is a longer-term 21 EMA on a two-hour time frame. As you can see right here. Let me get rid of this Fibonacci. You see this red line here. This was breached at that point. That's what this line is. This light red line you see right here, 68. Now, what you have here, if you do a Fibonacci study of the last big swing on the two-hour chart, what you'll notice is that the 382 level at that time, the 382 level at that time is 201.65 ish area, and the 50% level at 201.74. So right away, what you know is, aside from anything that the 15-minute or the hourly chart is telling you, that if it breaks that level, a retracement back to that 65 to 70 area is not entirely unlikely. Now, what you then want to do is a Fibonacci study of this move itself. Because if you're not in this, you're waiting for a retracement and you're looking for a good entry opportunity. So you do a Fibonacci study of the move of the day. And what you'll notice is that falls right around, the 382 falls around 54. I'm not sure if you can see that too clearly. Well, that's 54. And the 50% level is at 62. Pretty much overlapping with that 382 level on the two-hour longer swing chart that I just showed you a second ago. But I want you to focus mainly on the 15-minute. And at that time, also, the hourly point was right around here, which put the 5 EMA on the hourly right around the same point as the 382, I'm sorry, the 50% Fibonacci and the two-hour Fibonacci from the longer swing. So now you've got one reason, the 5 EMA on the hourly. That's one. And you got two, you've got the Fibonacci at 382. And then right, we'll call this entire thing two, actually. Say that whole 60 region, let's just say, because you have the Fibonacci on the 15-minute chart for today's move down, along with the longer two-hour time frame retracement. This is all happening. We're doing all this while price is still down here to try to determine where price might react so that we could possibly get an entry. And then what we do is when price nears that point, we use short-term confirmation with something like a 3-minute chart to get our entry confirmation and go for it. So one other thing we want to take a look at, typically when price retraces, it will retrace the 21 EMA, which at the time was up here. The next 15-minute candle starts a retracement, and lo and behold, look where the 21 EMA, that red line, ends up being, right about the same time as our Fib level. So now we have the 21 EMA as well. So what we're expecting, essentially, is this breakdown and a bounce up to either here or preferably to the 50% Fibonacci, which is also the 21 EMA by that time on the 15-minute chart, In the hourly 5 EMA and the Fibonacci 38.2 Fibonacci on the 2 hour time frame. Essentially a lot of resistance, okay? Right at this point and a bounce at that point for further downward pressure. So here's what actually ended up happening. Go to the very next 15 minute candle. Now, you'll see that 15 minute candle went up and hit pretty much to the pip on the fib level. Now, this is subjective. Whether you want to wait for that to hit to the pip, or I would honestly say that once you're in this range, you're pretty much good to go. But what you don't want to blindly enter a trade, because let's face it, this could be a full-blown reversal and keep going up. So essentially, prior to this 15-minute candle, and 15-minute candles, 5 3-minute candles, we'll go back one, you would want to be watching a 3-minute chart. And I'll pull that up beside here. Okay. During the same time frame, what you'll notice is stochastics are going up on this 15-minute chart. Now, as price hits 62 is the peak. That's the peak that it hit, the Fibonacci level. And what you'll see on this 3-minute chart is you start to get a stochastic rollover. So depending upon whether you're waiting for, let's go one more candle it gives you on a 3-minute time frame a stochastic cross. Maybe you want to wait, if that would be possibly an entry for quite a few people. So you're in from, depending upon where you got in, 50 to 55. Or maybe you want to wait for it to cross into the trade zone to be a little bit more secure, understandable. That would happen on the next candle, so that means you're in at 50, or maybe you even want to wait for a 5-8 cross. In that case, you're in here at about a stochastic cross and a 5-8 cross confirmation at about, 49-ish or something like that. Keep in mind, your stop is above the 55 EMA for a relatively low-risk, high-reward type trade setup. And as you can see, within it goes back up, gives one more opportunity, plays around up there, but keep in mind you're already in the trade based on the first stochastic cross, regardless of what it did after that, with your stop just about 20 pips away, and you're shooting for at least M1, probably the hourly 200 EMA at 201. So you're still in a situation that you're risking about 25 pips to get roughly 60, 65 pips and potential profit, almost a 3-to-1 setup, and you really can't ask for much better than that. Now, as you can see, looking at the 3-minute chart, the very next 3-minute candle puts you over 30 pips in profit, 20 even if you got in late, allowing you to move your stop. Once you're 15 pips in profit, you get to move your stop to break even. That's what we call minimal acceptable performance, is 15 pips. So if you hit 15 pips, you take that stop. Let's move this Fibonacci off here so I can give you a better. Let's scoot over. You take that stop that you had above the 21. Remember, you entered, depending upon exactly where you entered, somewhere in this zone, but your stop is in the same place regardless. Once you're down in that 30 region, it really doesn't matter. Your stop is now at break even, wherever that might be, and you're just riding it out here for your target. Let's see what happened. Riding the 5 EMA. You look at the hourly. It's riding the 5 EMA on the hourly here. Keeps going. Now, we're entering the New York session. Now, some people might have taken profit or scaled out some profit at this zone. Let me show you real quick. This is also a, actually, I can show you better on this chart. You'll see by looking at a 4-hour that green line at the time, 201.20, that green line you see is the 4-hour 200 EMA, and that's where it hit to the pip. Okay? And on top of that, you see a black line underneath of that. That is also, if you skip over to the weekly, as you can see, the weekly central pivot point. When you look at the weekly pivot point, you'll see that real thick black line is the weekly central. And they're overlapping, so we don't know at that point if price is going to hold there. But it's okay. You're already up, depending upon entry, 30 to 40-ish pips. So you lock in your 15-pip profit, or some people might have chosen to scale out a little bit of profit at that time. And still, we're in the London session. You're still riding the 5. Price retraces a little bit and then continues downward, never getting a 5-8 cross, never having a stochastic cross back into the trade zone, continues down to the ultimate target at 201, and then a little bit beyond that. Some people, most people would have taken profit at that point. Now, this continued into the New York session, and you could still be in this trade and still be up another 30-ish pips from the target. So what this ends up being is, even if you missed the initial entry, which was fantastic, there was still a very good high confirmation entry, let's just say anywhere in this area, to put yourself in a situation to very easily garner, give or take, around 80 pips profit, let's just say, taking spread into account as well. And I got news for you. You do 80 pips a day, that will keep the bill collectors away. That's a successful trade at fxbootcamp.com. If you wish to learn a little bit more about how to do our trades, how we do our trade setups, please come and visit us. Hope you guys have a great day.